Presentation of Retro Sports Network, home of the champions of the past, present, and or future. And happy Friday the 15th, January. We've survived 15 days of 2021. And today we go back to May 7th, 1949, Kentucky Derby Day, for a game between the 5-10 Chicago Cubs and the 11-7 Brooklyn Dodgers. The Dodgers find themselves tied for first place with the St. Louis Cardinals in the National League. No East or West, thank you very much. The Cardinals are ahead by mere percentage points. And so, we featured Bobby Thompson yesterday. We're featuring Ralph Branca today. That's how the baseball gods roll. The Cubs are going to go with Rush. I think his name is Glenn. Anyway, so the Cubs getting a token appearance on the channel because they are not very good. They are 5-10. They really don't have much of a chance to do much of anything this year. They still have Phil Cavaretta, Andy Pafko, and a couple others from their 1945 National League Championship run, but it's really not much of an effort. And so the Dodgers, trying to get into first place by themselves, they play the Cubs next! As Retro Sports Network presents Major League Baseball Replay 1949, today, the 7th of May, from Ebbets Field in Brooklyn, it's your favorites, the Bums, the Dodgers, and the Chicago Cubs. And today's game is brought to you by DigitalDice.com, the best podcast on the web for your sports simulation and replay needs. Find us today on Spotify, iTunes, Spreaker, or wherever else fine podcasts are listed. And so on a cool and windy day in the borough of Brooklyn, we find ourselves with some baseball for you on the channel. Ralph Branca, who was quite a smart man, and we'll get into that over the course. The game is on the hill for the Dodgers. He has not had the best of starts. He is only 23, the Hawk, a fastball pitcher at 91 and a flyball pitcher. Plus, does not bode well against right-handers. He last went 4 days ago on the third against the Reds and took a loss. Seven innings, 11 hits, 6 runs all earned. He walked 5 and struck out 6. And so in 24 and a third innings, he's allowed 30 hits, 3 homers, 19 runs, 16 earned, 23 walks, and 13 strikeouts. Yikes! But he is one of those rare pitchers in 1949 who did not walk as many as he struck out. Now, 91 and 186 and two-thirds innings isn't great, but he did manage to K 109. And here's a lineup he'll face, and at some point, you're going to get a mute because I'm going to sneeze here. Harry Walker is in right field. He'll lead off. Peanuts Lowry is in left field. He'll bat second. And you got to say that first name very, very carefully. Phil Cavaretta is at first. He'll go third. Andy Pafko, or Topps 1952 number one, is in the center field. He'll clean up. Walker behind the plate. He'll go fifth. Gustin at third will bat sixth. Verban is at second. He'll bat seventh. Roy Smalley's dad is at short. He'll bat eighth. And Rush is on the hill. Tom Sawyer was a mean, mean one. He'll bat ninth and should go about 125 pitches. Defensively for the Dodgers, much more of a lineup that you'd be familiar with if you are a fan of the old Dodger Blue. Gene Hermansky is in left. He is a 4-6. Duke Snider is a 9-8 in center. Carl Farrillo is an 8-10 in right. Billy Cox is a 5-3. Pee Wee Reese a 9 at short. Jackie Robinson an 8 at second. Gil Hodges, a 9 at first. Roy Campanella, a 9-6 behind the plate. And Ralph Branca is a 2 on the mound with a 9-1-3 fielding percentage. So Walker digs in at 131, a homer, and 4 RBI. 66 degrees of wind blowing from left to right at 18. Place your bets for the Derby later on. Pitch to Walker is a fly ball right center field. Snider has it, and that's how this one starts. And it's Peanuts, again, say it very carefully, Lowry at 370, no homers, and 3 RBI. Part-time duty for the Cubs in 49. In the left center, Snyder, second verse, same as the first, two out. For Phil Cavaretta, 255, one homer, and 3 RBI. A slow start for Phil. To short, Pee-wee, and that will retire the side. So the Cubs go down in order. No runs, no hits, no errors. It's Bob Rush. How about that? And so we go to the bottom of the first. The Cubs go down in order. Here come the Dodgers. Bob Rush has made one start on the year. He's just 23. He's a fastball pitcher at 85 and a ground ball pitcher. He lost to the Cardinals a week ago on the 30th. 7 2/3 innings, 10 hits. 4 runs all earned. He walked 2 and didn't strike out anybody. And did not give up a home run. He started 27 games in the replay, or in the real year, and finished 9. And again, another pitcher that did not walk as many as he struck out. Which doesn't quite cover himself in clover, but we'll take it. Pee-wee Reese leads off for the Dodgers. At short, Gene Hermansky in left will bat second. Duke Snyder, the center fielder, will go third. Jackie Robinson cleans up at second. Roy Campanella behind the plate bats fifth. Billy Cox at third will go sixth. Gil Hodges at first will bat seventh. Carl Farrillo sits in the 8 hole and right. And Branca, who threw 13 pitches in his half of the first, will bat ninth. Defensively for the Cubs, Lowry is at 8-7 in left. Pafko, a 7-7 in center. Harry Walker does not have much range. He's a 1, but his arm is good. He's a 7. Justine is a 5 at third. Smalley, an 8 at short. Verban, a 6 at second. Cavaretta is an 8 at first. And Walker is a 5 and a 6 behind the plate. Rush is an 8 with a 964 fielding percentage. Pee-wee, 270, 2 homers, and 15 RBI. And there's a ground ball to third over to Cavaretta, one out. So a change of games for you on Tuesday at noon. We'll not do St. Louis and the Braves. We will go to Detroit for the Senators and the Tigers, because someone asked for a Sens game, and they are over 500 and playing a team over 500. Here's Hermansky, 424, and 2 solo boom booms with a triple, and a ball 4. So Bob Rush lost him. 3-0 curve misses low for Snyder. 325. 4 homers, and 14 RBI. Got him. An 0-2 in there at the knees at 84. 2 out for Robinson. Jackie at 333. A homer and 10 RBI. Base hit left field. Lowry will pick it up. Hermansky jumps over to third. And so the Dodgers have runners on the corners and 2 out for Campanella. Campy at 231. Slow start for Roy. 3 homers and 7 RBI. And there's a fly ball in the left field. Lowry is there, and that will retire the side. No runs. 1 hit. Dodgers strand 2 after 1. No score. So Pafko, Walker, and Justine to face Branca here in the second. Andy, 200, no homers, and 9 RBI. Ball 4. Lost him. High and inside on a 3-1 curve. So it's a Rube Walker. He was a coach for a long time, too. But a lot of catchers do end up coaching. Anyway, 1-for-4 on the replay. 244 in the real year, 3 homers and 22 RBI. He does have an RBI in the replay. Throw to first. Andy is out. They got him picked off. Andy was going. Hodges threw it to Reese, and Pee-wee got the tag on. So 1-3-6 on the putout. One out for Walker, and now Rube, with nobody on, will bat. Into right field and very gone. Oh my goodness. That was left over the middle of the plate, and he sent that one into Queens. So the first home run for Walker makes a 1-0 Chicago. Middle of the plate. That's a 30-foot wall out there in right field. That is a pick and a poke. But he sent it down that line at 312 feet, and that's how the Cubs get on the board. And now the throw out of Pafko looms very large for the Cubs. That take a run off the board. Justine at 208. Frankie has a homer and 3 RBI. One out, 1-0 Cubs. Got him. A 1-2. Fastball at 91 on the outside corner. Two out. For Emil Verban at 286 and 6 RBI. Has 2 doubles. That wind is now blowing at 19 from left to right. Base hit left field. Hermanski will pick it up. A 2-out single. For Roy Smalley, 241, no homers, and 8 RBI. And there's a long drive to left field. That's off the upper deck, and it's 3-0 Chicago. So Smalley smashes that one, and the Cubs have a 3 spot here in the second. Even in Red Barber's catbird seat, that was going off the bat. And that settles in the stands. And that brings up Ross, who's 0-for-3 with an RBI this year. That's the beauty of baseball. You just never know. To third, Cox gets the glove up, and that will retire the side. But the home runs from Walker and Smalley give the Cubs 3 runs on 3 hits and no errors. We go to the bottom of the second. 3-0 Chicago. So here's Cox. Billy at 194. No homers and 6 RBI. Their good luck charm, Lorenzo, hasn't woken up yet. And the Dodgers are behind the 8 ball already. Slow roller to Cavaretta. Takes it to the bag himself. One out. You'll see the Dodgers and the Braves Wednesday night, we hope. Yeah, it's only 9 a.m. What does he know? How you doing, Brad? I owe you 2 emails or a supersized email. I had vertigo last night. Shut off the light, relaxed for a little bit, listened to some tunes. And when I went to move, the room started to spin. And I was sober. Didn't even have any Dunkin' Donuts coffee or anything. Here's Hodges. He's at 400. 4 homers and 13 RBI. Got him. 2-2 fastball at 84 right down Broadway for strike 3. So here's Ferrello at 221. 2 homers and 16 RBI. I wouldn't be doing this if I didn't feel well. Feeling much better today. Vertigo is something that, you know, it's a balance thing in your ears, and since I can't walk, I really can't hurt myself doing it, and so I feel just fine. But thanks for asking. 2 out, 3-0 Cubs. In the left field, crowd likes it. Lowry going back. It's gone. Gonna run out of real estate. He sent that one down the line in left field, and the Dodgers are on the board. It's 3-1. They're playing modern baseball here at Citi Field. So Ferrillo is third of the year. And there wasn't a blessed thing Lowry could do. It was a question of whether it would stay fair or not. It did. And the Dodgers are on the board. Here's Branca, who's 0 for 7 with an RBI and 3 strikeouts. Rush deals. Got him! He swings and misses at an 87-mile-an-hour fastball, and that will retire the side. Dodgers get one of those runs right back on the home run by Ferrillo. After two, it's 3-1, Cubs. So Branca, whose name rhymes with Sanka, 37 pitches for his first 9. That's not very good. 2 innings, 3 hits, 2 homers, a walk, and a strikeout. Now, I see Nia Watson. How many of you are familiar with the old game show concentration? Walker line drive to second. Robinson leaps and makes the catch. One out. Here's Lowry. Peanuts, and again, you got to say that slowly, is 0 for 1. Okay, Rick says he's somewhat familiar. We'll give it another minute or so before I go in any further. Lowry sends this one into left field. Hermanski's going to turn and watch that one go. Lowry puts that one in the second deck in left center. And it's 4-1. That's a third home run today for the Cubs. Mr. Forsberg is. The old game show concentration. You remember that? Oh, yeah, never mind. What were you at? I wasn't paying attention. Ha, ha, ha. You're funny. What I get for taking things at face value. Branca's given up 3. He gave up 21 all year. Here's Cavaretta. He's 0 for 1. One out. 4-1 Cubs. And he plunked him. Oh, ho, ho. That one looked intentional. Cavaretta and Branca exchange a couple of pleasantries. Cavaretta says something about the horse you rode in on. Yeah, I figured that after I read that. Okay, here's Pafko, one out. And he walked his first time up. So the old, if you're not familiar with the game, old game show concentration or classic concentration hosted by Alex Trebek, it was a pictogram game. You'd have 25 or 30 numbers, and you call out 2 numbers, and if you match the prizes, you got to look at trying to solve a rebus puzzle. Never very good. I liked the game, but was never very good with it. Well, Ralph Branca, after his playing days, of course, he didn't make enough money to retire in the 50s, had like a 5-day run on the show in the early 60s to the point where he was brought back to like a champions tournament, like 1963. And a lot of that champions tournament, where Branca is a finalist, is up on YouTube. You gotta be pretty bright to do some of that stuff. Did Branca cough up the championship there too? I'm trying to think if he'd won it or not. I'm not gonna spoil it because I don't remember off the top of my head, but if you look up on the tube for Branca and concentration, they're there. Pafko draws the walk. 3-0 in the dirt. As long as Bobby Thompson didn't play. You know, at some point, the word Maldito is going to come across the chat. Here's Ruben Walker. He hit a solo shot his first time up. 4-1 Cubs. One out, bottom of the third. Got him. The 0-2 on the inside corner. on the curve. Thompson lost his starting job to a future Hall of Famer twice. Well, I know the answer to this. One was Willie Mays, who was on deck when Thompson hit the home run. And the second is Carl Yastrzemski. Branko went to Ricky's high school. Frankie struck out his first time up. Two out in the third. Oh, Thompson. You know, Thompson's from Scotland. Did you know that? And there's no P. It's T-H-O-M-S-O-N. So Bobby is Scottish. Long drive to left. Hermanski, 7-1. Maybe it's a good thing that Mr. Lorenzo isn't here today. My goodness gracious, that's the second of the year, and it's 7-1. Again, there was no doubt about that one. My goodness. And I think it's fair to say that number 13 doesn't really have it today. So who have we got for long in the pen here? Well, Paul Minor is throwing about 9,000 times this year. So Jack Banta. Will come in. Jack looks like he could be Aubrey Plaza's grandfather, can't he? 24 years old, a fastball pitcher at 92, and a flyball pitcher. Pitched against the Reds on the 5th. I'm assuming that's a start. 7 innings, 8 hits, 4 runs all earned. He walked 3 and struck out 1. So, 21 and 2/3 innings, 19 hits, 9 runs all earned. He has walked 10 and struck out 5. And he indeed has made 2 starts of his 12 over the course of the year. But look, he didn't walk as many as he struck out. So he'll get 80 pitches or so. 2 out here in the 3rd. Here's Verban. He singled and scored. And he's going to single again. So, Ricky, did your high school play up the fact that Thompson was there? Happy Friday, Tribe fan. How are you? Verban on first. Here's Smalley. Roy, a 2-run shot in the 2nd. Brad's drunk already. Thompson from Scotland, but everybody knows the Bantas are from Tatooine. And happy, better in about 4.5 hours. That's when you get out of work. Smalley, ground ball to Pee-wee over to 2nd. And that will retire the side. 4 runs on 3 hits and a chased pitcher. We go to the bottom of the 3rd, 7-1 Cubs. This is your Saturday. All right. That's right, because you work from home now. So you do clients on Sunday, right? His number is retired, but it's not like a recruiting tool or anything. I would be surprised, although it is New York, how many 13, 14, 15-year-old kids would know who Bobby Thompson was. That's not the type of thing you'd hear about on a Fortnite stream. Retro Replays, how are you, my friend? Monday through Thursday, your clients. Sunday's a paperwork and prep day. Okay. Pee Wee Reese is 0-1. Russ, through 9 batters, has a 6-run lead. 30 pitches, 2 innings, 2 hits, the home run to Ferrillo, a walk and 3 strikeouts. And there's a ground ball to 3rd. Frankie relaxes and throws it away. So Reese will hold it first. The low throw. Cavaretta has to lead the bag. He's able to scoop it up. And that'll bring up Hermanski, who walked his first time up. Infield's playing back here. Do I drop one? I drop one. He squares. Bunt is down. Walker lets it roll foul. That didn't work. The count is 0-2. And another ground ball foul, first base side. So Hermanski working rush a bit. 0-2 the count. Line drive to Verban, who leaps and makes the catch, one away. For Snyder, who struck out his first time up. So these two teams, or the Cubs, the Cardinals and Dodgers are tied for first. Philadelphia a half back. The Braves and Giants are one back. The Pirates, Cubs, and Reds, well, 1950's coming. Go to your Studebaker dealer today. In the American League, it's the Tigers and the Yankees, and the Senators are four back. Senators and Tigers Tuesday at noon right here from Detroit. Cleveland, Philly, Boston, Chicago, and St. Louis had the Red Sox looking at Montreal to relocate. Boston is 2-7 away from Fenway. Back when the second division meant the bottom half of teams. Throw to first, Peewee back. Pitch to Snyder. Duke, ground ball, base hit, left side. So Peewee will hold at second. Runners on first and second. One out for Robinson, and Jackie's got himself a single already. This Dodger team has the firepower to score seven. The problem is, can the bullpen stop anyone else from scoring? Ball four, they're loaded. For Roy Campanella, who is 0-1. Up the middle, Rush throws home, and they get Peewee at the plate. So two out, it goes 1-2. On the card, and two out for Billy Cox, who's 0-1. So Snyder on third, Robinson on second. Single will make it a 7-3 ball game. Campanella can literally wheel around. Make of that pun what you will. Ground ball to Smalley. Flips it to Verban, and that will retire the side. Dodgers leave them loaded. No runs, one hit, and one error. We go to the fourth, 7-1 Chicago. So Banta to face Rush. And Bob is 0-1. Look, Banta's eyes aren't even focusing on the same thing. But doesn't he kind of look like Aubrey Plaza? Ground ball to Hodges. He'll underhand it to Banta covering for the out. One out for Harry Walker. Harry's 0-2. Ground ball to Robinson. Two out. She is fantastic. She is out there. Yep. Wonderful in Parks. That was just a great show overall. She is as awkward as anything. Here's Mr. Lowry. Peanuts, 1-2. Solo shot. First of the year. To Robinson. And that will retire the side. So Banta does his job. We go to the bottom of the fourth. Cubs go in order, but they lead 7-1. Her and Ron Swanson made the show. She played a great psycho in Criminal Minds. Well, I'm not sure how much acting that really was for Aubrey, but yes. Great stuff. Here's Hodges. He struck out his first time up. Ferrillo and Banta, who's going to have to bat. To third. One out. Ferrillo, with that home run at one point, made the score 3-1. And now the Dodgers are going to need to put some base runners on together. Trying to remember what the beer ad is out in right center field. I think it was Schaefer. And the H and the E, the Schaefer, see where Ebbets is out there? That was the Schaefer ad. And so the H and the E were lit signs. And so when the official score ruled a hit, the H lit up. And when someone made a boo-boo, it got the E. Farrillo, ground ball, base hit. So that would light up the H, and that's the fourth Dodger hit. So Banta's gonna, with one out, bunt. Justine and Cavaretta come in. One of those games that you don't want to burn the bullpen too bad. Walker throws to second. They get Farrillo. Someone who was 10 years old in 1949 would be 82 now. Yep, my dad would be 72 this year if he was still with us. But yes, this may be a wee bit too far in the past for everyone but Lorenzo. Lorenzo was born in 51. The bottom part of that sign, Tribe Fan, was for Abe Stark suits, or the top part, one of those signs out there. And so if you hit it on the fly, you got a free suit. And I'm sure Schaefer, because of, look, it's Brooklyn, and these were all neighborhood boys, probably didn't charge them much for the beer. It'd have to take a poke, though, to knock one of those lights out. PB Reese is 0 for 2. Russ threw 18 batters, 52 pitches, 3 and 2/3 innings, 4 hits. The homer, he walked 2 and struck out 3. In the left center field, Pafko has it for the out. No runs, one hit, and no errors. We go to the fifth. It's still 7-1 Cubs. So Cavaretta, Pafko, and Walker to face Banta. Jack, 4 outs and 16 pitches. Cavaretta's 0 for 1 with a run scored. Now 1 for 2, he punches that one in the left center field for a single, and he's hurt. Cavaretta grabbing his hammy as he's on first. Betty White, as she comes up in the chat, turns 99 this weekend. I love it. I forget who she was on the talk show couch with on one of James Corden's shows. But they asked the gentleman, what's older, Betty White or sliced bread? Pitch to Pafko. There's a fly ball to left. Hermanski, that will stay in the yard for the out, and Cavaretta will hold it first. So one out for Rube Walker. Pitching coach. He was a pitching coach for a long time. Rube struck out and homered. Not necessarily in that order. That's a base hit up the middle, past the diving Robinson. Cavaretta will hold at second. And the Cubbies have runners on first and second, one out. Sliced bread is the best thing since Betty White. That's the right answer. Betty White is actually older than sliced bread. Duh, there's a reason why they call it white bread. Here's Frankie Justine. He's 1 for 2 and a massive home run, a 3-run shot. Little number down to Pee-wee. Goes to Robinson for 1. I don't think they're going to get him at first. It's a fielder's choice. 2 out. So Cavaretta moves to 3rd. Justine on 1st. Verban is 2 for 2. Emil has single twice and scored. Pitch from Banta. Ground ball to Cox. He goes to Robinson for the sure out, and that will retire the side. No runs, 2 hits, no errors. Halfway home on a Friday afternoon here from Ebbets Field. It's the Cubs 7, the Dodgers 1. If you joined us late, here's how I got here. Rube Walker, a solo shot to make a 1-0 Chicago. Roy Smalley, then with a 2-run shot, this is in the second, to make a 3-0 Chicago. Dodgers clawed one back in the bottom of the inning with a Carl Farrillo solo homer. Then the Cubs broke it open in the third, 8 to the plate, and they scored 4. Peanuts Lowry, a solo shot to make it 4-1. Frankie Justine with a 3-run shot, to make it 7-1. Dodgers failed to score on a hit and a walk in an error in the third. Rush, 4-hitter through 4. The solo shot to Farrillo. He's walked 2 and struck out 3. Ralph Branca chased after 2 2/3 innings. 5 hits, 7 runs all earned. The 4 home runs were all on his watch. He walked 2 and struck out 2. And Boeing likes his ERA at 7.67. So Hermanski, Snyder, and Robinson here in the bottom of the 5th. Gene is 0-1 with a walk. Rush threw 8. Already did that. Hermanski up the middle. Pathko went out. So today's grocery day. You know how hard it is to find unsweetened iced tea mix? So I'm just finishing up my coffee. And if you're familiar with my channel a lot, you know the fun we had with coffee a couple weeks ago. I'm not a huge coffee person. Here's Duke Snyder. He's 1-for-2. He singled and struck out. There's a ground ball to Rush over to Cavaretta, 2 out. And so most of the time when the wife and I go out in the morning, when we could do that, I alternate between tea and coffee or iced tea. Because I like iced tea. But I'm not I know I'm going to offend my Southern viewers. I'm not a sweet tea person. I prefer my iced tea with a little bit of lemon and some sweetener, or just plain. And so I tried to find some plain iced tea. Jackie has singled and walked. He's 1-for-1. You know how hard that stuff is to find? Maybe it's just a summertime thing up here. I couldn't find it. I could find some sugar-free powder mix, but it was decaffeinated. And so I found a 12-pack of stuff, of the drink. And I'll drink it because it's got the caffeine in it. You know what the regular price is for a 12-pack of Lipton iced tea? $9.19. I got it for 5-something. There you go. There's my Andy Rooney rant for the day. Pitch to Robinson. Ground a line foul. Third base side, and somebody from Staten Island makes that catch. 2-2 the count. Up the middle, past a diving Verban, and that's a single. So the 5th hit for the Dodgers, and now bring up Campanella. Roy is 0-for-2. Robinson on first. Dodgers need to get some work done here. Throw to first, Jackie back. 70 degrees here in Brooklyn. Left to right, wind at 19. How many of you are expecting a snowstorm this weekend? To Smalley, this should be 2. Verban for 1, and they don't need it because there was already 2 out. No runs, 1 hit, and that's it. After 5, 7-1, Cubs. So Smalley, Rush, and Walker to face Banta here in the 6th. Roy, 1-for-2. He hit that home run. He's driven in 2. And he gets hit. And now I'm surprised that the benches didn't clear. Smalley just kind of smiles out to the mound. The second Dodger pitcher to plunk somebody. And Smalley's the one that hit the homer. Trout fan says, hope not, but might get some cold. I hope not freezing rain. Yeah, that's what we're going to get pretty much here is crap. In fact, Alexa, what's the weather in Burlington, Vermont for Sunday?
Currently, in Burlington, it's 32 degrees Fahrenheit with mostly cloudy skies. You can expect more of the same today, with a high of 37 degrees and a low of 32 degrees.
Alexa, what's the weather Sunday?
On Sunday, January 17th in Burlington, there will be snow flurries, with a high of 36 degrees Fahrenheit and a low of 26 degrees.
Thank you.
Of course.
My phone woke me up about 3:30 this morning. Rush, by the way, 0 for 2. We're going to bunt you. So Cox and Hodges come in. And the bunt has popped up. Campanella tries to chase. He's got it. One out. Yeah, you rush back about a half hour, 40 minutes late. Lots and lots of home runs for the Cubs. Here's Walker. He's 0 for 3. Banta has done well in relief. 41 pitches, 2 2/3 innings, and 3 hits. Smalley on first. So my phone wakes me up at 3:30 this morning to tell me we got a winter weather advisory for the eastern part of my county, not where I live. Thanks, telephone. He bunts that one, and they're going to try it for 2. And he doesn't even pick it up. So Campanella let it go. Should have picked that one up. So Smalley on second, Walker on first, Lowry at the plate. And this one's been all Chicago. Campanella gets yelled at by Banta in the left center field. Snyder, 2 out. Smalley will tag. And Snyder's going to throw here. To third, to Cox. He is safe. Okay. So runners on the corners. 2 outs for Cavaretta. 1 for 2 with a single. And a run scored. 7 runs, 9 hits, an error for the Cubs. They've left 3 on. The Dodgers, 1 run, 5 hits, and no errors. And they've left on 7. Ball 4. They're loaded for Pafko. Andy, who'd play with the Dodgers at some point, has walked twice and scored. He's 0 for 1. So Smalley on third, Walker on second, Cavaretta on first, 2 out. Ball 4, so Pafko draws the bases loaded walk. It's 8 to 1. So here's Rube Walker. Rube is 2 for 3, the solo homer, a single and a strikeout. Got him. So 1 run, 1 hit, and no errors. The Cubbies leave him loaded. We're bleeding Cubby blue today after 5.5. It's 8-1 Northsiders. So Cox, Hodges, and Ferrillo to face Bob Rush. Billy is 0 for 2. Into center field, Pafko, 1 out. Here's Hodges. He's 0 for 2 with a strikeout. Wind now blowing in straight from left field at 19. Into center. 2 out. So here's Ferrillo. Lone Dodger run came in the second on the homer. He has singled. And he draws a walk. And so that will do it for Banta. So who can hit a righty? Marv Rackley. Marv, 27 years old. We're playing 63 games, 6 for 10 on the replay with 2 RBI. Not going to replace Duke Snyder, so it's a pinch hit only. Walker and Rush have a conversation. Rackley to third. Justine, snap throw to first on the bang banger. Got him. And so that'll do it. No runs, no hits. The Dodgers leave on runner number 8 after 6, 8-1 Chicago. Bud Podbelin. Oops, nope. Can't do that. just don't have a lot of good options here. Lots of home runs. Well, Branca gave up four. Preacher Row. We'll finish this one up. First relief appearance. He's made three starts. Shad. It's a type of fish, isn't it? Last pitched on May 1st against the Phillies, he went the distance. Seven innings, three runs, all earned. He walked one and struck out eight. Holy. Holy, not 1949. Overall, 26 innings, 19 hits, eight runs, all earned. He walked seven and struck out 13. 34 years old, a fly ball plus pitching. The fastball tops out of the Bugs Bunny, 82. Home runs by Lowry, Walker, Justine, and Smalley. So Frankie, one for three. A three-run shot, that came in the third. There's a base hit in the right center field. He's going to dig out two, and he needs a triple now for the cycle. Emil Verban is two for three, a single twice and scored. Bring down the wrath of the big Dodger in the sky. Yeah, I think O'Malley's having some martinis right about now. Pitch to Verban is a base hit right center field. Justine will hold at third. And the Cubs have greeted the preacher with two base hits. It's not the offering he was after. Here's Smalley, his two-run shot, part of the Cubs outburst. I went with Walter O'Malley. One for two. He has scored twice, and there's a fly ball to center. That'll bring home Justine. Steiner's got it. 9-1 Cubs. Yep, future daddy of Roy Jr. So one out for Bob Ross, who's 0 for 3. Base hit left field. So runner is on first and second for Harry Walker, who's 1 for 4. So Preacher Row, the sermon kind of falling on deaf ears right now. Shad. Again, that's a fish. Kind of like a chum. To third, this might be two. Cox to Robinson for one. He'll hurry over to Hodges, and the Dodgers go across the horn. Trying to get me in trouble in chat. Here's Pee Wee Reese. He's 0 for 3. Rushed through 27 batters, 6 innings, 90 pitches, 5 hits. The home run to Ferrillo, that's the lone run. He has walked 3 and struck out 3. And it make it 4 as Pee Wee swings and misses on the curveball. Cooled off Ruben Walker a bit, but that was about it. Here's Hermanski. Gene is 0 for 2 with a walk. To Verban. Two out. Sens and Tigers Tuesday afternoon, 9 Pacific, noon Eastern. Here's Snyder. Duke 1 for 3. Has singled and struck out. Wednesday night would be the Dodgers and the Braves. From Boston. Base hit down the line and left. Steiner's got two. He's digging for three. The throw to third down in time. So Brooklyn trying to get something together here. A two-out triple for Jackie Robinson. And the Cubs have yet to retire him today. He has singled twice and walked once. Pitch to Jackie. There's a ground ball to Frankie. Throws to first, and Jackie beats it out. So it's now 9-2. I knew that the dams would start flowing through. Here's Campanella. Roy is 0-3. 9 runs, 12 hits, and an error for the Cubs. They've left 7 on. The Dodgers, 2 runs, 7 hits, and no errors, and they've left on 8. Pitch to Campanella. Struck him out. Make it 9. 1 run, 2 hits, and no errors. We go to the top of the 8th. It's 9-2 Cubs. So Lowry, Cavaretta, and Pathko to face the Preacher. Peanuts, a solo shot. He's 1-4. Base hit, right center field. That's going to go all the way to the wall, and Mr. Lowry's got himself another double. That's 3 on the year, and that'll bring up Cavaretta. Watt scored and singled. He's 1-2. Liner Snyder throws to second, and Lowry is back. Here's Andy Pathko. 52, number one, is walked 3 times. Scored and driven in a run. In the left center, 2 out. Lowry will tag and hold for Rube Walker. As they're yelling at me in Spanish, Ricky says, I didn't realize we hit the SAP button in the chat. Buenos noches, amigos. Walker is 2-4. He is singled, homered, and struck out twice. So now looking up the insult. Not often I get called human excrement in my own stream. Tigers play on Tuesday. You wait. We'll put the Reds back on when they get lambasted by the Cardinals. Here's Walker. We'll give you his numbers anyway. Tigers and Nats or Sens the next game. Pitch to Rube is 3, so Rowe got him. No runs, a hit, no errors. We go to the bottom of the 8th. 9-2 Cubs. Okay, so what does it mean, Lorenzo? It'll be Cox, Hodges, and Ferrillo and a pinch hitter, maybe? I don't know. I think Rose got to finish this one out. I was using Google Translator. And it said that my poop smelled like roses. Billy's 0-3. Scum. Scummy poop. Again, it smells like roses. Cox lines this one into right field. Walker will pick it up. And so that's the 8th hit for the Dodgers. Gil Hodges is 0-3 with a strikeout. Oh, I could, because Crossley is one of the fields that's already done. I don't even have to spend any time setting that one up. And trust me, threatening me to manage the 49 Reds, yeah, you'd expect them to win anyway. Pitch to Hodges is a ground ball to Rush. Only play is to first. Cavaretta on the bag, and Cox will move to second. For Mr. Ferrillo, 1 out. Carl is singled twice and walked. Hit his 3rd home run of the year, and he's driven in 17. Into center field. Pathko has it. Cox will hold. Spoken like a true fan of the team. I don't root for the Reds because they win. I root for them because I love them. Well, let's see who I have that can hit. Who can hit a righty? Well, it's going to be Tommy Brown. True love does not depend on another's performance. Yes, I've been with my wife for the last 25 years. Tommy, 0 for 2 on the year. 303 in real life with 3 homers and 18 RBI. Yeah, he doesn't root for the Yankees half the time, unlike some other people. Pitch to Brown is a fly ball to left. Lowry's going back, and that's gone. 9-4. So the Dodgers are at least are going to make it interesting for the Cubs right there. A pinch hit, 2-run shot from Tommy Brown. Granddaughter's name is Julie. Downtown Julie Brown. Drove that one all the way to the Long Island Railroad. So some lucky fan on the first deck caught that one down the line. Brings up Hermanski. Or brings up Pee-wee Reese, rather. Pee-wee 0 for 4 with a strikeout rush, 36 batters, 124 pitches. 7 2/3 innings, 9 hits. He's allowed the 2 homers, Brown and Ferrillo. He has walked 3 and struck out 5. And Pee-wee up the middle, Smalley over to first, and that will retire the side. Well, the Dodgers have made this interesting. 2 runs, 2 hits, and no errors. We go to the 9th. It's 9-4, Chicago. The Dodgers never fold. They'd always go down fighting. Well, we'll see what we got. I mean, they got the heart of the order coming up in the 9th. And now, it's Bud Podbelline. Bud is 25. He's a righty. Fly ball pitcher. Fastball at 88. He's pitched twice. He's pitched against the Phillies out of the pen twice. Last time was 1 inning. He walked 1 and struck out 2. So 3 innings this year. 2 hits, or 2 walks and 2 strikeouts. 12 1/3 innings in real life. 9 hits. He walked 9 and struck out 5. Lead the Britty Hose out of this. Okay. Smokey Burgess will pinch hit. And when Smokey sings, you hear violins. Smokey 1 for 4 with the Cubs. An RBI and a single. To Reese, 1 out. Here's Verban. He's 3 for 4 today. He has singled thrice. And a run scored. Into right field, Ferrillo. 2 out. Well, it's lining up well for the Dodgers. Hermanski, Snyder, and Robinson with Campanella, should anybody reach. Here's Smalley. Roy Sr., a home run. His 1 hit. He has scored twice. Ball 4. So here's Bob Rush. Let's see what the Cubs do here. He's 1 for 4. But he's thrown 129 pitches. So it's kind of leaning Brooklyn's way right now. He stays in the game and strikes out. 2-2 looking. The curve up came in for strike 3. And so, no runs, no hits, and no errors. The Cubs have left 9 on. So have the Dodgers. The Cubs 9, the Dodgers 4. So Hermanski is 0-for-3 with a walk. And so you got a tired pitcher out there facing the heart of the Dodger lineup. You're making the folks out in California think you got a chance. 1 out. That's Lowry. Here's Snider. Duke has singled and tripled his first of the year, struck out and scored 9 runs, 13 hits, an error for the Cubs, and 9 left on. Dodgers, 4 runs, 9 hits, no errors, and 9 left on. Bay line drive to center, 2 out. Thought that was going to drop. Pathko got there, and Jackie Robinson is the last chance saloon. And remember, it's Schaefer, not Maldito. Jackie, they've yet to retire him today. He has singled 3 times and walked once. And drove in 1 of the Dodger runs. And there's a base hit, so a 2-out single for Walker, got a bad jump on it. And so Jackie is coming on. You're going to see a big thing on the screen, but the Cubs are going to the pen. We got a pitching change. This game coming to you from Ebbets Field in Brooklyn. Well, that's the banner headline says that Jackie Robinson has 4 hits today. Let's meet Dewey Adkins, shall we? He's 31 years old. Fastball tops out at 88 and a fly ball pitcher. He last went on the 3rd against the Braves. He went 3 2/3 innings. He allowed 3 hits. 1 run, it was earned. He walked 2, but look at this. Of the 8 outs he got, he retired 7 via the strikeout. For 1949, that's worth your weight in platinum. 16 1/3 innings, 16 hits, 7 runs, all earned. He's walked 6 and struck out 13. He is 1-1 with a save. Campanella is 0-4 with the strikeout. Robinson dancing around first base, but you don't want to be the last out on the bases. Right back to Adkins, and the Cubs will win this one 9-4. So the Dodgers fall a half game out of first. Bob Rush gets the win. 8 2/3 innings, 10 hits, 4 runs all earned, the 2 homers. He walked 3 and struck out 5. 9 runs, 13 hits, and an error for the Cubs. They go to 6-10. The Dodgers fall to 11-8. 4 runs, 10 hits, no errors. Justine with his 3-run bomb is your MVP. Ralph Branca didn't drink the Sanka. 2 2/3 innings, 5 hits, 7 runs. The 4 homers, 2 walks and 2 strikeouts. Banta pitched well. Rowe hung in there, and Podbelin did okay. So, no, you didn't miss much. It was one of those games that was kind of over early. And so the Cubs do the job. Now it's time for you to look at me. So our next game is going to be the Tigers hosting the Senators on Tuesday. And so let's play the rest of the day in baseball. Well, the first thing the Senators do is lose. They lose to the Browns 3-2. Starr 2-2. Walt Masterson gets the loss. He's 1-1. Roy Seavers 2-4, his first of the year. A's beat the Tigers 2-1. Brissy, sounds like something you get out at a barbecue place, gets the win. He goes to 1-1. Fred Hutchinson falls to 2-1. George Kell 4-5 with 2 doubles, and very good discussion on YouTube about other good hitting third baseman. Cleveland beats the Red Sox. Bob Feller throws a shutout, 1-0. Don DiMaggio goes 2-4. Mel Parnell falls to 1-2. Phillies beat the Pirates 7-4. Schoolboy Rowe goes to 2-0. Chestnut 0-2. Ralph Kiner 2-4, 6 of the year. Giants beat the Cardinals, so we still have a tie in the National League. Clint Hartung goes to 1-4. Harry the Cat Burkeen falls to 2-2. The Braves beat the Reds 7-6. Hogue gets the win. Harry Gumbert takes a loss 1-3. Tommy Holmes 3-5 with a triple. And the White Sox beat the Yankees 7-6. Kuzawa gets the win 1-1. Page the loss 1-2. Gus Zernial hits a homer and drives in three. Well, Cal was, I said, underrated. Yes, your eyes. Burkine, right? It's not Breachin', is it? I thought it was Burkine. Someone will correct me. They always do. Yeah, it's Burkine. Standings, as we say goodbye, you know who's in first place in the National League? The Philadelphia Phillies. Cardinals, Dodgers, Giants, Braves, a half game out of first. In the American League, Tigers and Yankees are tied for first. Cleveland and Washington, four back. Philly, 4.5. Chicago, 6. The soon-to-be Montreal Red Sox are 6.5, and the Browns are 7. Well, it would be for 1950, and so you just never know. Philly plays a doubleheader on Sunday. So do the Braves. So does Cleveland. So does that. So there you have it. So we're back with you Tuesday for the Tigers and the Senators. Wednesday's game will be... Oh. Look at the right day. Will be the Braves and the Dodgers. Thank you, sir. And then the Thursday game is scheduled to be the Yankees and the A's. So, all sorts of good stuff coming up. I'm Ron Juckett. We'll talk to you soon. Have a good weekend, everybody.